follow his feet. He knows where you're sitting. Home, here is your seat. Though the town where you live may be far, far away, pretend you are here in this seat for today. Now, this is the theater from inside the doors. And this is the program. Yes, take it. It's yours. Your program, your ticket, your seat, and your show. Is everyone quiet? On your mark? Get set? Go!
Anyone else around here making music?
Well, is there?
Mr. Cloud, it takes more than just an orchestra to make music. If you go back into the audience and sit down, I'll tell you all about it. It takes three to make music. That's how music is made. By the man who writes it, the men who play it, and far whom it is planned. It takes three to make music. It doesn't take any more than the man who writes it, the men who play, and for they're playing it for. If nobody writes it, there's nothing to play. Nobody plays it, there's nothing to hear. Nobody hears it plainer than day. You haven't got music, now isn't it clear? It takes three to make music, so folks just listen to me. The man who writes it, the men who play, and you who hear it must be equally important, for music takes three.
Isn't that interesting? The man who writes it, the man who plays. What do you call a man who writes it?
Why don't you ask the audience? I bet they'll know.
What do you call a man who writes the music?
The composer!
That's right.
But Miss Martin, if you were really a composer, what kind would you like to be?
Me? Oh, I know. I've always known that. The kind of composer I best like. I like the daylight, sunlight for writing. It's warm and inviting to me. And I'm inspired by the things I see. I took a little walk to the end of town. I went to see the harbor where the boats belong. I hurried up home before the sun went down. And I wrote a brand new song.
And you wrote a brand new song.
I took a little walk into Central Park. The dew was on the flowers and the grass was wet. I hurried up home.
before the sky got dark. And I wrote a string quartet.
And she wrote a string quartet.
I'm a composer who loves to compose. 'Cause when I am ready to start, all I do is depend on my eyes and my ears and my nose. And I soon have a tune in my heart. I took a little walk in the big wide world. When the day was done and when the sun was red, I heard a lot better because the music was curled inside my head. Let me out, let me out, let me out, let the music, that's what the music said. So I wrote me a symphony. I think that gives everybody a pretty good idea of what the composer is like, the man who writes it. But you haven't asked me about the men who play it, the orchestra. Don't you want to meet them?
All of them at once?
Oh, no. The orchestra is divided into four sections anyway. So I'll introduce you to them just one section at a time. May I present the violin, viola, the cello, and the big bass fiddle to you. Violin, viola, cello, big bass fiddle, say how do. Strings can sing. Obligato are thick, thick, thick with a tricky little trick called thick, thick, obligato. May I present the piccolo, the clarinet and oboe and the big bassoon to you. Flute and oboe, big bassoon and clarinet and piccolo, say how do. Winds can blow high and airy, and when they go way down low, my, they're scary. May I present the trumpet and the French horn, the tuba and the big long trombone to you. Big long trombone, trumpet, tuba, and the French horn, say how do. Brass can play, bleak and bellow, and though it's rare, sometimes they're sweet and mellow. May I present the xylophone and cymbal, the timpani and knocking wood block to you. Xylophone and cymbal, timpani, knocking wood block, say how do. Now that we have the discussion too, I'm proud to present the orchestra. The orchestra. I want to congratulate you. You really did sound wonderful. Didn't they sound wonderful?
Yeah!
Now, let's see, where were we? We've done the man who writes it, the men who play it. What's left? Oh, yes. The folks they're playing it for. That's you, the audience.
What kind of an audience do you suppose they are?
There are only two kinds, good and bad.
But how do we find out which kind they are?
Why don't you ask? Go on. Oh, all right, I will. The usher shows you to your seat, and you forget to thank you. Your sister kicks you with her feet. Pull her hair and spank her. What kind of audience are you? Is that the kind of thing you do? You whisper, wiggle, squirm, and hum, and crumple. What kind of audience are you? Is that the kind of thing you do? Do you creep and explore all around the theater floor? Do you sleep or pretend you are dead? What do you say when a hat is in your way? Do you say, lady, please remove your head? You take your program from your lap, the plane it makes is dead. The show is over, you don't clap, you're counting all your candy. Is that the kind of thing you do? Oh, how I wish I knew. What kind of audience are you? You. What kind of audience are you? You certainly aren't that bad audience I was talking about. I think you're just a wonderful audience. And a good audience is what we love. A good audience is what we need. Cows need cats, clowns need laughs, plants need rain to make them grow. And we need you, indeed we do, 'cause you're one third of our show. Cats need mice, skates need ice, cows need gas to make them go. And we need you, indeed we do, 'cause you're one third of our show. The music maker makes one, the music player makes two, but the music hasn't begun till we have you. Now everybody sing the last part of it, but real, real loud. It takes three to make music. That's how music is made.